Work. I've been playing Black Ops. I've just been lazy, effectively. So, yeah, when I get my new PC in January, though, I'm gonna maintain daily uploads. But for now, just bear with it, all right? I do apologize. But anyway, we've got what the if I can speak, we've got the Premier League predictions. So let's do this. The Premier League kicks off tomorrow. I'm really, really excited. After all that's happened, the Paris attacks, all the other bombings, etc. It's nice to, return to normality, and that is football Premier League style. So anyway, the first game we've got Watford going up against Man United. Now, usually I would have a full match preview of this, and they will be returning next week, but for now I won't, so I'll go through it now. Watford are fairly solid, all right, under Kiko Flores, who's actually been praising David De Gea a lot. He was the one who gave him his debut for Atletico Madrid, and I respect the manager a lot, but these are the teams you have to be beating, especially if you want to win the title. Ultimately, that's what we want to do, Manchester United. So we have to do that. We haven't conceded in 555 minutes, so I think we're going to keep a clean sheet. We have got six injuries. Martial, the biggest one. We've also got Wayne Rooney out, so we're without a striker. Fellaini, the striker, is also out. So that's all three first choice strikers out. So we're going to have to either start James Wilson. I don't think he is injured, though he might be, or Marcus Rashford, who is in the squad for tomorrow, or Memphis up top. But anyway, other people we've got out is I think Carrick is the other huge one. Obviously, Shaw's been out, but we've got six in total. The defence, though, seems as though it's going to be fairly solid, so I really don't expect us to concede, and I do think we will get a couple of goals. Hopefully, Louis van Gaal plays Schweinsteiger in a more advanced midfield role alongside Herrera instead of playing a more defensive. Schneidlin can do that by himself. So yeah, I kind of want like a 4-1, 4-1-2-3 really, like just a CDM with two CAM slash centre mids with wingers and a striker. Anyway, this went on for too long. I reckon we're gonna win 2-0, and I reckon Memphis, if he starts, will score. Hopefully, anyway, because he needs some confidence. Anyway, the next game we've got Chelsea up against Norwich. Who would have thought this is a must-win game for Chelsea to even be in contention for top four? It is crazy. Literally, they have to win this. There's no excuses. If they don't win this, I don't think there's any prayer of getting top four. I still don't think they're going to get it even now because they're 13 points off it. It's possible, but the way they've been playing, I know they improved against Stoke, but they still lost ultimately. So it's going to be a lot of work against Norwich, though. I do like Norwich again, but it's at Stamford Bridge, and Chelsea did play well against Stoke. He Hazard actually looked a bit like a small shadow of himself from last season. So I do expect them to win this. And again, I think it's going to be a 2-0 victory to Chelsea. Next game, we've got Everton going up against Aston Villa. Everton have been utterly amazing this season so far. Aston Villa got a really, really good draw against Man City. That was fantastic. They had to do it. And Match of the Day analysed it, and it seems as though Gaudy loves his players to have one or two touches. So that's an interesting dynamic. Can Aston Villa players cope with that? They did well against City. I don't think they're going to get too much out of this. It's at Goodison Park. Lukaku's been on exceptional form. A lot of their players are looking really, really strong, Everton. So again, I think it'll be relatively easy for Everton. I'm going to say another 2-0. Literally, there's so many 2-0s so far. 3 out of 3. But next one, we've got Newcastle against Leicester. This is going to be an interesting game. Newcastle played absolutely dreadfully against Bournemouth, but they won. And then they played really, really well. Was it Stoke? And then drew. And there's another game they played well and lost. And yeah, it's just one of those seasons for Newcastle. But they have to be winning this, even though it is Leicester. Just to get some belief that they're not going to go down. They are fighting relegation at the minute, so if they could get 3 points against a high-flying Leicester, then that would give the squad immense belief. But you've got to beat Leicester. Vardy might be injured, I'm not entirely sure, which would be a massive blow to Leicester, considering he's isn't he scored like there's like Drinkwater doing really well. So although Newcastle probably will play well in this, just because they're hard to pinpoint what they're gonna do, I still think Leicester will come out with a win. I reckon it's gonna be 2-1. It'll be edgy. I can see it ending a draw, but I'm gonna say Leicester 2-1. Next game, we've got Southampton going up against Stoke. Southampton have looked really good recently. Stoke again have looked fairly good. So I think they'll cancel each other out. I can see this one being an entertaining draw to watch, but I've just said, like, literally, it's going to be a draw, in my opinion. It's going to be 2-2. Pella is finding a lot of form at the minute, so I reckon he's going to score. I'm not sure who's going to score for Stoke. They've got a lot of talent, though, so we'll see. Next game, we've got Swansea going up against Bournemouth. I really feel for Bournemouth. They were absolutely all over Newcastle, and they've got their best striker, Callum Wilson, injured. They were creating chances for days. Couldn't put them away because they didn't have a proper striker. I reckon Glenn Murray has to start this one because he is a default striker. And I think he's a bit underrated. He's done well for Palace and he's done well for Bournemouth at the minute when he's actually been given game time. But I still think Swansea, even though they haven't been great recently, I think at home they will pick up the points. And I'm going to say it's going to be 3-1 to Swansea. Next game we've got West Brom going up against Arsenal. Now, Arsenal have been absolutely terrific, and Ozil has finally justified his price, alright? I think the reason a lot of people don't like Ozil is because every time he does something, like a little flick or a little pass, Arsenal fans are all over it, you know, they have to be in your face with it, and that is why people, like, just don't like him as much as they should. Like, if he wasn't hyped up when he wasn't doing well, I'm sure a lot more people would like him. Now, I'm sure Arsenal fans don't give a fuck if people do like Ozil or not, but I think that's why he gets a lot of the stick he does. If he played for any other team, people would probably love him. But anyway, you have to admit, he has been absolutely terrific alongside Sanchez this season. And I do expect Arsenal to beat West Brom, even though they are usually good defensively, especially at home. I still think they'll have a little too much. I'm going to say 2-1 to Arsenal. Next game, we've got Man City against Liverpool, the biggest game this weekend. Now, this is a real chance for Klopp to show that his Liverpool side, even though it's hindered with injuries, can compete. They've just beaten Chelsea, who obviously haven't been amazing recently, but they did beat them. And now they've got a big game against Man City, and they can prove a lot. But the only problem is they've got some key injuries out, and also Benteke didn't really have the best of games last game. So he's going to have to be fully firing, and they're going to have to be perfect to beat Man City. I don't think they're going to, though. Man City will have too much. I think Aguero's back, Silva's back. That really isn't what you want to hear when Kevin De Bruyne is also in the form of his life. Kompany looks really good in the defence alongside Otamendi. So yeah, I just see this being a City win. I reckon it's going to be relatively comfortable. 3-1 win for Manchester City. In the next game, we've got Spurs going up against West Ham. Spurs, honestly, they've been terrific this season. They really have. They lost. The only game they've lost is thanks to a Kyle Walker own goal at Old Trafford on the opening day. And they haven't lost since. And it's easy to see why. The two centre defensive midfielders they are deploying are really holding the game up and allowing the front four, Lamella, Eriksen, Kane, and I've completely forgot the other one, it's blown my mind for the minute, but anyway, it allows them to go forward, and they finally, Kane's finally found some form, so it's working, it's clicking. Dele Alli and Eric Dyer allow them to do that. Alderweireld, really, really good buying defence. Lloris, great as a goalkeeper, and yeah, they just look terrific, and I think they're going to get the points here. West Ham, obviously hitting with that ridiculous injury to Dimitri Payet for like 3 months, that's going to really, really hurt them, and I think because of that, they're not going to be, well, of course they're not going to be as big a threat because he has been terrific by the season so far. But I think Spurs will win this, and I'm going to say it's going to be 2-0 to Spurs. And in the final game, we've got Crystal Palace going up against Sunderland. Now, this game probably won't be filled with goals, in my opinion. I'm sure that's many people's opinion. Crystal Palace have looked fairly decent, and Bolasie's showing some of the form he did from last season, and they have been very solid. Sunderland, on the other hand, have been below par and are relegation favourites, like one of the three favourites to get relegated. So they need to try and pick up at least a draw here. I do feel for Sam Allardyce, though. They weren't too bad against Southampton, and they lost thanks to a penalty. So it's one of those games, but I just think Crystal Palace will have a little bit too much for Sunderland, and again, like the first three games, I'm going to say this is going to end 2-0 to the home side, Crystal Palace. Let me know what you think of my predictions down in the comments below. Do you agree? Do you not? And yeah, peace.